Hello everybody and welcome to the XRL GP2 Division here for round 8 in Austria. As always, this is our reactions, all Joe, and we are always joined by F1 at Speed. Always good evening to you, Wes.
We all always are, aren't we? Anyone that has to do it this season has to say that.
We are consistent.
I'm consistent. Aha!
I'm always here.
This is true.
I'm always here for you.
You're always here as well, yes, that's true. You were here even when Bobas did it. Second race, I believe it was, of the season.
And thankfully, because it's GP2, the drivers are normally here, and we do have a full grid. Unfortunately, Alexham has not made it to the qualifying, but he has joined the lobby. But we do have a full grid as it stands, and we do have a wet race on our hands. I think it's a 38% chance of rain for the race. So,
and we all know, me and you know, I was busy doing something else, so it's a good thing you noticed that, because I just didn't have
the good thing I noticed that. It's a good job I know weather patterns around the circuit.
Good thing
I always
that
actually
I do, of course.
Study that. I don't know why. Because whenever I do an F1 division race, it's always dry. It always is.
Yeah, they used to have a problem in F1, but they weren't. I think it was in a couple of seasons ago. That's why they bring in the whole why certain tracks were clear, because most of the time they had like a wet race every single race of the season, nearly.
Yeah, that's a good thing.
It was a good thing to watch. It was a great thing to watch. Drivers got a bit annoyed.
No, I wouldn't.
I believe.
But anyway, back to qualifying. We do have a few quick drivers in here. Neymar's coming on pole this 107.6. We're expecting quite a tight field because of the nature of the circuit. There's only 9 turns, and of course, it's a very, very quick lap time. The quickest lap time of the season. So we'd expect things to be tight. He's got a 107.6. Has to be one last night in F1 division. Very quick pace. Has actually just been to place the first.
Yeah, Andy 7.7. Seven as well. Just a bit of
improvement
on himself.
Yeah, he's improved fractionally. Evansy's in fourth and is 7.9. Davies 2/1000ths behind Evansy in fifth on a 7.9 as well. Heard is a word. Who's been promoted to this division, I believe, is on an 8-flat. John Digweed is on an 8-3. Captain Waiter is on an 8-6. David Tass on an 8-8.
Oh, Phil someone
Knight
improved.
Who...
Oh!
John Digweed's
improved. Bird's in the wall. Bird is in the wall. Bird's lost a strong wing.
Yeah. Phil Knight, who is a reserve, but may end up getting the permanent seat, is currently the last of people setting a lap on a 9-5.
Bird through... Turn number 6 had too much understeer and went wide onto turn number 7, hit the gravel and threw him into the wall on the inside and lost his front wing. He's out of the way of everybody though and will be going in the pits as soon as possible.
I've just seen Andy come into the pits and he has done what you shouldn't be doing in the race. I'm not going to penalise him.
Yeah, in the race.
The white line really, really badly like that. I think it may be worth having a word with the drivers before the race.
Oh yes, that's a good point. If no one said it in...
No, because nobody said it, so I'm not going to do anything for qualifying. She's not going to gain an advantage. You know.
Yeah, we did that yesterday.
Yeah, I made sure I was clean. Don't worry about that.
Yes, everyone did.
I have to watch out for. In terms of, because we always say this is a wheel trap, but pads can do well in it. How many wheel drivers?
Alex Ham.
Who's with a wheel? Alex Ham, and he's going to have to start at the back. Because unfortunately
1-8-2 by Phil. Yeah, I think that's the only person really.
Sam would have been on a wheel, but he's in GP3.
Oh, where was that? Oh. Where is that? That's in a straight line. That's before turn 8 and 9.
Yeah, that's a.
Can you blow your engine up on this game?
I'll send him a message and ask you. That's straight. Dude, were you on board with that?
No.
But
it looked. His dot was on the track, so maybe.
Yeah.
I don't even know, because he's pole at the moment, isn't he? So, and there's loads of time left to improve.
He's on pole, so he's set a good time. But that's a time which can definitely be beaten, because we see this last night. Did a 7-3.
David went. Done a 7-9, just then went 7. Is there an invisible wall somewhere down that?
I've never seen that before. Neymar doesn't have a mic. He does.
Yes.
Well, he's Polish, but he does speak surprisingly good English with the messages he sends me. So, Andy's into third. Who's improved?
Phil
Evans
has a 7-7. 7-7 by Phil 6.
Yeah.
Was he?
7-5 for Evans.
5-5-5. That's the same as XRL Bobbitt did yesterday.
Yeah. and he did well in the race yesterday.
Your sarcasm much, but damn.
Sarcasm? Damn, we love it. So yeah, Neymar, the best he can hope for is second place. I'd love to see what actually happened with him, but, you know, we don't have footage and we're just going to rely on his word, because that's a very strange thing to do. You know, you wouldn't do it deliberately.
Not with 6 minutes to go.
No.
And if you're on pole, by not much.
I mean, the only thing I'd do in qualifying, if like, if the time's run out and I'm on a lap and I don't want to complete it, I'd just probably corner cut and get out of the way.
177 by David Tass, that's in fifth. Yeah, that's understandable.
Seven. There's very close
skipping
to
loads. One, two, three, four, five people all on 1 minute sevens.
Seven four. So he's extended his advantage at the top to just about a tenth and a half over Neymar.
Yeah.
Well, can't improve. So the people who can improve is Andy. He's currently the highest. So
he's going around the last corner now.
Second.
Last corner now for Andy. Let's see what he can do. He's about to cross the line. It's a 1 minute 7-3. It's pole.
Yeah, pole. Yeah, as I was saying, outgoing. Well, he's been displaced. If I now can't even say that word, because Andy Francis pole lap. So outgoing did a 7-5 to put him now third, and Andy has got pole 7-3. So the times are coming down here.
It's
as quick as yesterday.
There is about five people on a 1 minute 7-7 at the moment. And David Tass will be pitting, yeah.
I did say it would be a very, very tight field. And yeah, it's looking that way. Esu Pez, currently sitting fifth, he's on an outlap, I believe.
Yeah.
He got pole position yesterday, which only just...
And the win.
He got that by a country mile. He definitely got strong race pace on there, one to look out for, even if he does start. He does play low down for fifth for him. Considering the pace he had around here, but
in this division, it makes no sense. In the division, this division, that's not really too low down. But then again, if you go by his performance, what you said yesterday, then it is low down. It's pretty weird.
Yeah, well, there's more people in this division.
Yeah, this is actually a tough division. John Digweed is not going to improve from seventh.
I'd almost rather be racing in this division. Because it's such a nice division. Alright, this is quite a competitive division.
Yeah, you tell me who's going to win this race.
No idea, you could pick from any driver on the grid pretty much.
Yeah.
Except for me, or you, because obviously... Yeah. We're not going to race, unfortunately. I'd love to, but...
Smoking herb, which is a GP3 driver, here as a reserve in the Red Bull. Same with Vice Versa GP3 as well, so there's two drivers from GP3 racing tonight to see. You get some practice in, really. Really good practice, you would say, for tomorrow, even if there's a chance of rain. You never know, it could rain tomorrow as well in GP3, which is looking close as well there.
Yeah, it's about to complete a lap now, it's come around the final corner, it's all nice and clean. What is the lap time going to be? It's a 7-6, I thought it was going to improve a bit more than that. Doesn't change position, though. And he is only 4,000ths behind Neymar in fourth, so everything them two did on the lap and are separated by just that fraction of a second, it's, you know, it's quite mind-boggling really when you think about it.
Just
how small the gap really is to some people.
They could have taken a completely different line as well.
Oh,
he's unplugged his mic, he's dropping the controller or something there, you could hear it.
That's unfortunate gameplay right here. My dinner is ready.
It's a 1 minute seven by her. No, it doesn't count somewhere. Oh, that's unfortunate.
And he's on an outlap. There's only 2 minutes of qualifying there. I don't know whether I should wait a couple of minutes. I'm going to wait a couple of minutes.
And you still need to go and game it as well to tell the people about...
Yes, but we can wait for a little bit.
We probably will.
Gonna come around the final corner and just coincidentally on him again. It's just by luck. Is he gonna improve?
Yes.
Improved to a 7-4 and that puts him third, so that's a good improvement by him there. Outgoing's on a lap, but he's only
John's just come out of the pits.
Is not on a competitive lap.
No, he pulled over to let someone through earlier, but the waiter's just come out of pits, he's gonna be the last guy. Really, he's going for one flyer.
Yeah, he's just about got enough time, so he's fortunate with that. Davey is about to start a lap. He's got dirt in his tyres. Davey, the championship leader, only in 10th place. He's only about half a second off pole, but...
There's
a car right behind him as well, which is on a lap, you'd think. But there's a word... He's got an M plate missing, bird is a word. That's very strange. Around this track, you don't normally see damage. Eyes the first two in reserve, and tonight is in 12th. I'm still bored of him actually, because he looks like he's about to complete a lap. He's got a bit of dirt on his right rear tyre, but it shouldn't affect him too much. See that off. He's taking a nice couple of corners clean. I got
and he's going for one more. He's going for one more run.
Is this going to improve to time, but not position?
Pair improved a little bit. He's gone to second. He's still in the 1.74s.
I got a message from Neymar saying what happened. And right, this is interesting. I wanted to look only for a moment on the phone, and before the last corner hit the wall.
Oh, he was texting and driving. That's actually quite funny. That's happened before. I can see where he's hit the wall, to be fair. I can see where he's hit the wall. That could make sense in my head. It's raining. Raining and qualifying.
It is. There was a 0% chance of rain.
There's raindrops in qualifying.
There was actually a 0% chance of rain.
This game is broken.
It's starting to, well, it's not going to affect the drivers at all. But, you know, the cloud cover, and it might drop the temperature of the tyres a little bit, but it should be fine.
Well, yeah, because the qualifying's over, technically.
And if only going to improve on his time, he's... He asked how I came on track when he's a bit of a slide on the final corner. Is he going to improve on a 7-3? I don't think so. No, it's not an improvement. So he is under threat from other drivers, as I have a black screen.
John Digweed, 1.73, he's second.
This is so anticlimactic. There we go. It's definitely 3,000ths off pole. John Digweed. 3,000, that is agonisingly close.
It's down to bird is the word. I think he's the last one. He has a bit of damage.
It's all gone.
It's all gone.
But that is the end of qualifying. So in the end, it even says 2,000ths now. So Andy Ferrandi getting polled by the smallest of fractions out of John Digweed, putting that up.
Wow, that's close.
Esri Pair and Evansy doing good qualifying there. And third back, it's just so tight, really, you know. Apart from smoking up, it's a bit of an outlier there. Never really got a lap in a second covering the top 12. Incredible.
Yeah, smoking herb didn't get a, when he was on his second lap, he went off somewhere, causing him not to.
I'm going to quickly go for a second, for obvious reasons.
Why was smoking sitting on the line when he wasn't even on a lap? I didn't see that at all.
No. Alright, I'll be back in a minute, Wes, but I'm going to have to go into game chat and tell him about it.
Yeah.
About the pit lane exit. Yeah. So if you want to come game chat, so speak to the drivers.
Yeah, might as well. Might as well get some point of views.
Fine. Hit lane entrance.
Yeah.
Don't cut it. In the race. Don't cut it, because you will get penalties. Who did I see do it? In qualifying.
It must have been Andy.
Because I remember seeing a Red Bull do it. But yeah, I'm not going to penalise anybody in the race for doing it.
In quali.
In the race I am. Bloody hell. Yeah, that's the way it works. Oh, go away. But yeah. So just make sure to take that clean, because I don't want to have to give penalties and pit NX, you know, that should be easy. But the entrance, you've got to be clean into it. So just a pre-warning for you lot. You will be getting penalties if I do see it. But I'm going to quickly collect my dinner. Wes, speak to the drivers. Speak to them.
Please don't.
I won't then, David. Screw you.
Yeah,
ha! I don't have to say anything. I'm fine. No, that's always GP3. Any final words? No, not really, no.
And Joe's gone to get his tea, and yet the race has been
Joe's gone to get his tea, and someone has started it.
Banter.
Inspirational.
Banter.
But banter. So how long do you reckon it's... We can time Joe to see how long it takes him to get his dinner now. More than 30 seconds is probably going to be how long it's going to be.
Good luck, guys. Keep it clean, keep it... as entertaining as we always have.
Yes, good qualifying. Very close. Very close qualifying.
Sorry, that's the F1 division. Banter.
Yeah.
Yeah, we're more entertaining than F1. We should be relabeled F1.
God, it was so boring last night.
F1 plus
one. I'd quit of boredom.
Right. So, actually, gotta put it onto this screen. Someone's gone. Joe's not here. Celebration, not really. This could be
somebody
fun.
Can start at the time
Joe's go. Joe got here at good timing.
I got here at good time. Somebody
started
time. I don't even
that
know.
That took you actually 30 seconds to get your D. It
that
literally,
was brilliant.
As soon as you left.
We're
as soon as you
get
left.
Get away with Alex Hammy's on primes.
I you
on
do.
Primes.
You
oh,
go left.
Yeah.
You go left. Because I'm not going to move. I'm not going to move. Go left in front of me. Because otherwise you're going to get in the way because you're going to hit the wall.
Yeah, and we're away for round 8 of the GP2 division, who's made a good start off the line. Andy Friendly has made a good start. There's Williams on the inside. The Lotus not quite made it. Is there any contact further back?
There's a Lotus spinning.
There's a Lotus spinning. That's going to be Neymar because...
There's four wide.
This four
is okay. It's
Neymar
not four wide anymore.
Done. He's got a lot of work to do to get ahead. Andy Friendly's got a decent lead. Oh, it's so tight near the back there.
It is.
Position. Everyone's made it through
formed.
Pretty nice, except for unfortunately Neymar on the first lap. He's, you know, we didn't quite see the actual impact. But
Williams has gone wide. That's Alex Ham. He's lost a place in the background.
Into breaking
turn three.
Williams. His teammate John Bigwig has dropped position to third. Pet has got into second.
Waiter's trying to get a Red Bull. That was a good move. Gave him a nice little tap, but he's on the option, so he's always going to be quicker. And that is a rare. That's got to be Davey passing the Red Bull as well. I don't know what Red Bull day is of. They're not Andy, so it's the other one. It's Smoking Herb.
Yeah.
And
Davey. There's a McLaren there. He's had a massive run out the final corner. It's Captain Waiter who, you know, had a much better run out the final corner on Phil's night in the Ferraris. On the inside, there's a big contact and...
There's a bit of flying.
He's
free wide now.
Everywhere. They're free wide now.
Oh, they
so
stopped
David
out.
Profited from that really battle. Is this going to end well into turn two?
Wow!
Break a lot later.
Free wide,
David
got
round. Put in and he's been rammed off to Davey.
He got no damage, but...
He got no damage. But
that's interesting because it was three wide into that corner, so...
The championship leader's got it all to do now.
He's last.
I need to sit down and eat my dinner.
What
oh
the hell was
God.
That? He's at the back. Quit laughing at him, man. That was mean.
That was mean.
That was horribly mean. That was horrible. How could you do such a big...
I'm so
Davey
sorry.
First, Andy for Andy second, and Captain Wet third, so XRL Bug. I'm going to keep calling him XRL Bug, even though he's different game tags to XRL Bug. So that's his predictions. We didn't get to do one because I'm already up, but I can't predict, so I'm not going to even attempt it. I'm not even going to say, no, Phil's might hit the back of a Red Bull in the last corner, saves it from out the wall, but that's a place and a bit gone. That was a sad incident that happened there, and this is a real fight between these guys on the prime. Smoking Herb out breaking the Brett and McLaren lows into turn one. I think McLaren just broke super early. This pack is interesting because now the Williams has been passed by as the best and a Ferrari as well. And that Ferrari is now trying to help. It's Phil coming back at the McLaren. And Davey's involved, Neymar's involved. I don't have a clue what's happened at the front. I've been at the back the whole time, so we're going to go on this screen. And it's Andy, Pear, and there's 10 seconds.
The front two are pulling away.
There's 10 seconds for both McLarens on lap number 3.
It was very wide there on the exit of turn 7.
Yeah, that's what Buzzword did in qualifying, ended up in the gravel, then ended up in the wall. He's in 6th place as well at the moment. He's starting 10th, I believe, so that's a good start from him. And that's a bit of contact between the McLaren, the waiter, and the salvo of David Tass. But they sort it out, they're both in the straight line.
Oh, Perry's got a massive moment out of the first quarter. Oh my god. How did he save that? That was a massive chance up. He's lost well over a second. He's going to be outside DRS range. He was closing on Andy there quite considerably, but wow, that was incredible car control.
Wait, throws it up the inside of David Tass, turn number 3, and he missed his brakes complete. That was pointless. And David Tass is saying, thank you very much for that. And he's also got DRS, but he's not using it. Interesting.
It's broken.
I think it might be. That might be a reason why he's dropped off the back of his teammate in 6th, and that's why by KSL going into 5th place at the moment. Ricardo XV says, someone first, someone else second, and someone else third. And we've lost connection to Andy.
Wow.
He was winning.
Wow.
Yeah, that's very unfortunate.
That is so unlucky.
Mick Super, that side by side for sixth place it is. Round on the two last corners, and that's David just staying ahead, trying to give each other room, which is all fair enough. Gary has sent you a message, and evening, gents. Evening, Gary.
Evening, Gary. Hello, Gary. Wow.
I'm pretty sure doesn't evening have an N in it, but I feel like it does.
Sorry for Andy there.
You do. You had a very good chance of a podium. We are only on that 5, but the laps here go very, 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 very quick, and it's only 36 of them today compared to 71 yesterday, and that's a good cutback again by David on Waiter, and the exactly the same basically as last lap. Bit closer to this lap from Waiter to try and take it into turn number 3. If he just late lunges a little bit, and he could do it, he's gonna try and feed it up, gives him a little bit of contact, bit of a slide out the corner, and he is through. So the British touring car style really turned through, but Waiter has now got past David Tass for 6th place. And there's a car off. That's a car off. Who the heck's that doing rallycross? That's Bird is the word, deciding to do rallycross, and he's now lost 2 positions. And he's just got completely ruined tyres. He's now down to 7th. He's now behind his teammate as well. So something went wrong for Bird. They dropped it somewhere, or maybe it was contact. I haven't managed to see.
Oh, it's a battle for 2nd. Here's a Ferrari on the inside of John Dewey. Turn 1. John Dewey leaves a space. He goes wide, and the Ferrari does go through. And that is Evansy, so Evansy is into 2nd place.
Here comes outgoing for 3rd, possibly into turn number 2. Maybe he's definitely going to DRS for turn number 3. John's a bit later on the brakes than everybody else. That may have been a cut by outgoing, and he's just gone with the traction, so he's kind of ruined his own chance there. Now David has got DRS, it's working now, and he's on it. Waiter, he's going to go up the inside of Waiter, turn number 3. Revenge from last lap, that's an easy move. If he doesn't get the undercut, Waiter tries the undercut, but David is into 5th place. So their battle continuing on. Oh, there's different braking zones between the two, different lines with turn number 4. Or number 5, I think it is, Edward.
5, 6, 7, 8, 9, yeah. Is because of the rain, which is going to come at some point.
Oh, where was he? Where was he? Waiter pits. Waiter and Bird pits.
They pitted really, really early. If they heard something about the rain, which we don't know.
I don't know.
But Neymar has gone.
Neymar's gone. Where was he? I didn't see a dot really far behind. Maybe.
No. He retired, didn't he?
Yeah, he retired.
So that's very strange.
Bird's work got some primes options for Waiter. But, yeah. I don't know. So 2 cars now out. And I don't know about that second one. That one's... Davey is now up to 7th. Trying to feed his way through these prime runners. He's on the options, but he's stuck with prime runners at the moment. Davey's on his own now in 5th. Because of Waiter and Bird pitting.
Oh, John's run very wide there on the grass. That is very wide down
the exit 7. Saw that from on board outgoing. Not the best corner, but outgoing's got a lot better one. He's going to give him a tap, and it's because he's carrying so much more speed than John there, so. Yeah, that's a lot more speed. More pitters, there is a more pitter. It's smoking herb. Three cars now pitting, and it's options for him, so two options, and two cars have gone on to options, being Waiter and himself, of the smoking herb, and then Bird has gone on prime, so I don't know, that doesn't tell me rain, call for rain, does it tell you call for rain?
No, not really.
Three cars pitting and different strategies completely there. The average...
Not that going a that big moment maybe. Out the corner there.
Third, actually hasn't finished the race for a while, I would say. Sam Digweed, recently a quick driver in this division, still not won a race in XRL, which still shocks me. I know.
Outgoing hits very late.
Do you want to write that one down? Yeah. Do you want me to run and grab my pad? I need my pad anyway, so I'm going to grab it.
Fortunate for him. But what tyres has he gone on to? David has been
option.
He's gone on to front. David's made his way up to fifth after been doing a lot of corner cutting duties. I wasn't bothered about going. Phil's gone to options as well, so the majority of people I think have gone on the options for another spin.
Yeah, one guy's gone on to prime. That's the word.
Chicken and chips.
They sound crunchy.
Yeah, this particular chip has been done by my mum, so it's better.
It's been done by my mum. No Ash wins. Yeah, well, there's one more with the David one, but, you know, three wide into turn number two. Kind of expecting a side pod.
Well.
Neymar's one, yes. And I think that's John pitting, wasn't it? Because he looked like he was very, very... Yes, he was definitely pitting because he was so slow and going in the white lines. That he is fine, and then David Tass is in the pits as well. I'm tired of everybody jumping onto the stove.
Should really be another set of options for everybody.
Prime for both of them. Prime for the both of them. So they've just kind of equaled out how much people have gone on options and how many have gone on prime. So that's going to spice up the field because there's a lot of people going faster than them on the option. And Blake has got himself up to 8th and just behind John Digweed. So he was nowhere near him before pitting. Nowhere near him. Already on lap 10 out of 36. So, you know, and we're still expecting the 36% chance of rain it is.
That feels like 36 or 38.
Yeah, so it's
high 30s.
Definitely in the 30s, yeah. So message, of course, there was one from XRL, but a lot of dive bombs, hashtag Yeah, quite a lot of dive bombs were going on. I think that was due to Michael and David Tass, their little battle was full of dive bombs on each other. Well, David Tass not as much, but more Wader. And there's a more pitting, and that's second place, I think, in the pits now.
No, Wader's quite an aggressive drive when you think about it.
Can be. David has just gone in the pits and wow! Nearly clipped the wall going into the pit lane. He would have just crapped himself. Evans, he goes on the prime, so another car going on the prime. But yeah, he can be quite angry with the driver. I'm racing with him. And that is Evans coming out behind Eyes the Best. Only just for Carly now.
Hey, Paul. Williams of Alex Ham into the first corner.
Outgoing
options.
Outgoing stuck in a train of primes, even though he's on the options. The only person that really hasn't had it. Eyes the Best hasn't pitted. I know that for sure, and knows Alex Ham or the champ, the leader of the race, which is now in the pits. If I'm looking at the map.
I've pitted, so. Yeah.
What
tyre did he going to go on to? Because a lot of the front running people are now on primes.
Yeah.
He's gone into another set of options.
Okay, he's got the lead to do that. But they're all being held up by the guy who hasn't put a name, Eyes the Best. That was a massive corner cut by outgoing. You cannot take that place. You've technically taken the place. If you continue, you're going to take the place, aren't you? You are. Taking the place.
Down.
Yes, please. Oh, do you want me to write? No, he's letting back through. He's decided that he was going to let him back through, so I don't need to write it down now. Hello, Jake, Wes, and Joe, says. Oh. The XRL button. He says, because he is eating. Someone else has just come out the pits. That may have been Alex Hand pitting, I don't even know. Neymar sent you a message. Evans, he dives one a little bit on Eyes the Best. Give him a little tap, and outgoing is just going to follow him through. Eyes of S's eyes will be a bit shattered compared to the rest. Now outgoing on the inside of Evans, turn number 4 or 5, I think that is. So, yeah, it's going into 6, then 7 here, of course. because I was trying to think if it actually counted as a damn corner.
Oh, Davey has had a big moment out of turn 6A. He's got on the gravel and the dust and the dirt. Davey is not having a good run of it this race. At all. Very unfortunate.
Maybe he's pushing too hard. Well, everything's getting to his head. You know, everyone's getting to him. Outgoing is now into second. That round. Oh, Sauber at the first corner and then smoking heavy. I was driving the F1 division. So, not very happy. Neymar, we're going to leverage in the old trip for you. What? I don't even know what the heck that was. The message was
Gary sent that message.
It was something different.
Well, I chicken head, I will, so it's gonna be Gary.
I will read it quickly. Since Gary is watching, hello Rebecca. Okay, Paul, I'll just accidentally click back on that one. It says hashtag Azaka. Oh, ask Azar. So I was trying to figure out what the heck that word was for a minute. But it is actually a hashtag ask Azar. Is a chicken head meal better for you at 11:30 PM than a Big Mac meal?
Chicken legend meal is always better for you. Bird is a word, is in the pit. Very close to it. He had two wheels over the white line actually coming into the pits. So.
Oh, yeah, that's it.
Yeah.
It's crossing it, sadly.
No, it is crossing it.
Hate to be too harsh, but. Either be as harsh as you can, or people will just not, you know, brake and slow down to pit entrance. They do the tactic of just not, you know, turn really late.
I mean, the margins are very fine, you know, every driver's going to push the limits, but, you know, you've got to have a certain limit. And unfortunately, in this case, a few drivers are falling foul to it. We did say this.
We're going to have to pit again at some point. When it's wet, so I don't know if the wet will be probably when it's wet, if we should be a bit more lenient. Ricardo sends another message. Ryan says hey to Malene Vines. Okay. We're just saying hello to a lot of people on the stream, this is happening today. Sam, Brendan says B, and then Sam's still on the chat, says that dive bomb. Gary, you're sending another message. I'm going to miss him. Tell Barton I saw that slag today, and that's a good move by Evans, and that's a cutback by outgoing, and he's just because he's got the better tyres, he's on the options, he's going to go back through. The fact that he said tell Button, well, if Button's watching and you've sent me a message saying that, he's going to know.
Yeah.
Crazy vicious in your mission. This is the part where it's something to do with it. Oh no, it's going to be how the exams were, I believe. That's how it looks. Because I asked him earlier. I had a nice conversation earlier. Let me just check if it is or not, because it may be something to do with it. I have two more exams. Spanish tomorrow and music on Thursday. That is our division head. Getting cloudy, says Jack, because it is getting a bit cloudy, would you say as well, Joe?
A little bit.
They just want to send me to get me to his bay. Is it his bay? Ah, oh, very nice for you, Ryan. To have a bay, that's a lag. A little bit far out going. A little bit cloudy. They just really want to resend my messages. I'm probably stupid about that. Now I'm getting. I'm not lap. The amount of times I had to press the middle button was ridiculous. And another message as well. Evans up the inside of outgoing once again. This time no cutback. Evans outgoing. Side by side, outgoing. Good traction. Actually not getting ahead, but he's got the inside of the next corner zone, number 5. And he's going to stay ahead. And it's a nice cutback by Evansy.
Hampton Way has got ahead of our best week. I think that is team orders.
That was sexy. Evansy, good cutback through turn number 5 to get him into turn number 6. We have a Williams on the back of him as well now, John Digweed. He's getting involved. It's a freeway for second, allowing Pear to run away. And that's outgoing pitting.
Outgoing
decides to pit. Yes. I've got my notepad though.
Very good. He learned.
No.
Oh, did he actually cut it?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, God's sake.
Yeah. Went on the, you know the little white bit for the advertising?
Yeah.
He had some wheels on there at one point. Samson says, my name is Jeff. They just said my name, Jeff. Doesn't even say is, I just thought of English. Is would be perfect. They're outgoing again onto options. He's come out in the middle of a battle. That's not what you want. That's the
that's
McLaren
the
battle.
McLaren, he's come out between. Can't tell where he's going. His eyes are best going to squeeze ahead. They're going to be very tight into turn number two. All eyes best to hit his teammate a little bit. He's got a bit of a tap from outgoing. Unfortunate there. Nice.
Thank you.
Oh, that was the best there. Just missed his breaking point. As Captain Waiter, I think has got a run.
He has.
On
Alex Ham.
The winning's just thrown about Alex Ham. He unfortunately had to start at the back because he missed qualifying and outgoing on the fresh option tyres is all
he's
over
stuck.
The back of him.
He's stuck.
He's so much quicker at this stage.
He's getting held up massively.
Nothing he can do. He's moving to some clean air. That's the way it's a bit wide. That was out on the corner and a bit wide out of the final corner as well. Getting a bit messy. Well, towards the back of the pack, really. Outgoing, looking for any way through he can, but this is such a hard circuit to actually overtake on. As he has actually got a good run out of turn one, is he going to get a long second out of turn one into turn two? It's technically turn three, isn't it? Or turn two. I don't know.
I call it two.
He's on the inside. There's a little bit of contact, but he does get through fairly. Outgoing.
He's going to get
sixth place. There's a little bit of barging between the two of them. Outgoing just about gets the place. Outgoing has got ahead of that pack just in time.
Battle for second.
Oh,
the McLarens.
Wow.
McLarens
left on. He's hit the back of his teammate, Captain Waiter. That is not good news
did
at
he,
all.
Did he turn into early and just hit the back of him?
Well, he had a moment out of six. And, you know, I was best went past him and there was nothing Captain Waiter could do. He just hit the back of his teammate. It's very unfortunate, but...
So was that more Waiter trying to correct the car instead of his teammate at the time?
Oh, I'll write it down.
Yeah, it's a bit unfortunate for the team of fans there. So you said earlier about teamwork, team orders and teamwork. Didn't go to plan there.
No, it didn't go to plan, but, you know, it's unfortunate, but, you know.
I just come on board. Davey, he's just randomly weaving. So, okay then, Davey. I understand. It's okay.
See what Michael just did there? It looks a very stupid mistake, but it's very easy to do, because I've done that a number of times in practice.
Because I look at your messages with loads of kisses and love art. Did I get another one? Oh! Okay, that's Paul allowing random stuff there. That's like kind of what Gary did before, like asking a girl out. I think we've just kind of had the same thing, but with marriage.
Nice.
Button asking somebody if right. I'm not gonna get involved. Love in the air. John Digweed in the pits now, going on to some option tyres, and also in the pits, David Dass going on to some options. So they've done the same thing.
Definitely clouding over now.
Yes.
But I should think in-game chat they've heard the call for rain because it will. It's definitely
lap 20
in 15 minutes.
Alex Ham is behind his teammate John Digweed. They're technically not teammates because Alex Ham should be in the red ball with the rider. That's got to happen. Today, but he's allowed to drive in the Williams. Gets a nice little tap, and there's a nice little tapping. Smoking Herb goes ahead, or vice the best. There was a lot of tapping there. I don't know what actually happened. I didn't get to see because of weird camera angles with the hills and stuff going on. What generally happened there, but Smoking Herb get past vice the best.
A
bit of banger racing, I feel.
Me a message. Can I watch? Can we invite him in to watch or not?
We've done it before, we've invited him. Yeah, because he's no longer in the lobby. If we're here to watch, so I don't see why he can't be here to watch. So he can come watch if he wants.
You know.
Smoking Herb at the... Alex Ham pitted and he was keeping within the lines. They had to slow Smoking Herb down. Yeah. Ryan, hi Jake, and hi Ryan and Jake, how are we this evening? Asking Bud and Soda, but all conversations going on. They are probably actually in an Xbox Live party with each other just to be annoying. We're now on lap 21. And still 21. No rain. 20 seconds worth of penalties for smoking herb now. In game.
Definitely clouding over.
I definitely don't know. The fastest lap is Pears by about a tenth to outgoing. Pear just seeming to like this track, isn't he? He said yesterday, no rain. He didn't want any rain. There's rain. So now we've got the point of, he needs the gap before that he's on. He's got more than the fifth straight gap.
That is a massive gap.
Baby being in that third place.
Wow, so he's doing an incredible job to get up there. I might have a look after I've done my next person corner cutting after this lap, look at the race director for pit stops, just to see
fastest
what everybody's sort of done.
Yeah, fastest lap is now definitely John Digweed. He's got to be just on 179 on that lap. But he's the best now in the pits. This
will
be his second stop. I don't know, because I only got on board when he was in the pit lane. He's the best. On to some options. So I would know, this is now one angle Will Gaming handing me a message. I'm good, thanks, you. Some more messaging between themselves there. I think this is going to come out around about 12th place. And that is last. And that's pair quite close.
Everyone only stopped once. Everyone else stopped twice.
Everybody else stopped twice, so that's why our pair is that far ahead and close to lapping, really. Ricardo says, I'm feeling inspired, Paul. How are you? Those are kisses. Ricardo really is either filled with joy or filled with love, or he's just found out he's gay. Either one. Could be any of those.
He's definitely not getting.
Ooh, oh shit.
Controversial.
No, not even. Wow.
Ah. Oh. That slipped out of the pump. Ah.
Did it.
Oh. Ah, that's the burn. The burn is
you're
real.
You okay? Did that hurt you?
That hurt.
I bet it did. Oh wow, that was a fun. Good evening, how is everybody, says Matty. I'm good, how are you, Matty?
Yeah, we're good.
Lovely.
We're good.
Yeah.
Paul sent me a message.
Oh god. No, they got a minute delay, so surely you haven't heard that.
I'm not gonna read it out.
Yeah, you are.
I'm not gonna read it out.
Why not?
I was about to say I'll text you it, but you've got your new phone, ain't you?
No, you could text him. You can text it to me because I've got the other phone next to me that's got
Facebook
my number at the
moment.
That'll
be easier.
No. Please just text me because then I'd have to go on Facebook and it might have to stream. Just text me. It should come up.
All right, I'll picture it in bit.
Yeah, no, now.
No, because I'm doing corner cutting. I need to look at my screen.
Yeah, put your phone screen next to your Xbox screen and there it is.
No, because I'll look down at my phone. It's just
you look down on things. Evan Z is gone on to some options. Because my height difference. Davey now in the pits. Let's for some more options. Yeah, you're not. Now my messages are being resent, so you're gonna have to.
Yeah, well played, everybody. Well played for spamming him. If you want messages to be read,
Matty says good thanks. Feeling great, Jake, now that you sent me kisses, you are my world, bae. And then those more kisses from me. Everybody has suddenly decided that they are amazing young teams.
I could just Facebook you it, because I'm just send you a picture of it.
It's Snapchat not me, then. Snapchat it, then.
But that involves internet.
No, it doesn't. It involves 3G, doesn't it?
That's internet. You could go on Facebook with 3G.
Yeah, but then I'm not my wife. Oh, that's true. Yeah, but I'm not on my Facebook on this phone, so you can't... That is Davey trying to pass somebody. And kind of failing, actually. Can you just text me?
I'm chatting you now.
We'll do that. Oh, there is some chaos on my screen. Oh, Davey going...
I will wait a lap, because I just realised I've got one more lap on this specific
I have to turn my Wi-Fi on. It's according to this. I think it's automatically turning my Wi-Fi on as soon as I go on Snapchat. Oh, apparently I'm not logged in anymore, it just logged me out. It better not be this, you are finding every time I'm on. Outgoing just comes out the pits. So that is me accidentally changing the camera angle so you can see a McLaren coming straight at your face. There's rain.
The rain is coming.
It's pouring there.
Quite hard. It does come very hard round here. In Austria. Smoking up. It stayed out quite a while and he's got a Ferrari behind him. I believe that should be Evansy right behind him. And it is.
Yeah, it will be. No. Oh, John Digweed's in the lead. Just behind him is Pear.
Evansy has passed Smoking Herb before. Got turn eight.
So we do have a fight for lead.
Really bad options.
So Pear didn't know he'd go on primes because the raid's coming down, but he went on primes, so he would have been quicker if he would have on options. But just to clarify, you don't actually need to if you're going to go on the inters or full wets to go onto the and both compounds. But maybe he thought the rain wasn't actually going to come, but it's here now and kind of screwed him a little bit going on those tyres. But either way, he's still battling for the lead on John Bigweed. And up the inside turn number two, very slowly in turn number two, around about 30 miles an hour, just slow for another one car to go. It just feels like you're going about 1 mile an hour. And that's Evansy on the option, so Evansy is going to be a bit flying fuzzy. That rain looks a little bit like snow to me.
It's definitely coming down very hard, it's smoking up, it's struggling in the option tyres. Evansy is going to be on fresh options. Because Pear has made a bit of a strategy, you know, it's
error.
A bit strange.
Strategy error. It's
it
an
is
error
very
a little
strange.
Bit. It's more of an error because maybe he just, I don't know. I don't know what he's thinking there. Maybe
John Digweed
he didn't get
does
the call.
Have the effective lead of this race at the moment. So, and it's going down very hard. I do believe before the end of the race we will see the full wet tyres at this rate. It does rain incredibly hard around here.
We are on 27 now, 36. Less than 10 to go, so yeah, I don't see why we can't in the 10 laps and less than 10 laps speed of full wet when it's going down this hill. Not seeming to affect him just yet, mentally, yes, definitely affecting straight away. Everybody is now trying to feel the track, feel and calculate and everything. That's all they're doing.
David
and at the same time, pass.
On this lead group. David Tass is having quite a strong race at the moment. We're not.
He's an average, yeah. He's always there and thereabouts. He's one of those drivers as well. John Digweed still hasn't won a race, and he's now leading this race with 10 to go. So I'm really happy for him at this moment in time. But he's gonna have to fight for it. So is Evansy, and
really
so is Pear. And
these
two have already won a race this season in GP2.
They are definitely championship contenders.
Evansy won the last one. Pear won in Bahrain. He's also won. One F1 division race, and there's a little bit of contact, and it's a bit chaotic, and everyone's pitting. Everybody's pitting. Everybody is. All three. I don't even care. I'm not even going to count them all for crossing the line because they all just at the same time hit each other into the pit lane. They could not do anything about that. They're all going on inches.
I'm going to bring consideration the fact everyone's on slicks on a wet track now. So
And the fact that they all had a fight into the pits and hit each other. Yeah. John Digweed is going to come out. No. Evansy's leading. Evansy is leading.
But
from the pit lane,
up.
John's third, and Perry's second.
Who
so
is that staying out? That.
Outgoing, I think, or Davey, it's one of the Mercedes. It's Davey.
Davey?
Man,
he's in the lead?
He may have just...
No,
that's a back marker. That's a back marker at the front. That's somebody that I think went on inches too early, one lap too early. Or something like that.
He's
fifth, Davey.
He's not struggling badly.
Let's put it this way, he was on the back of the Red Bull going into turn two. Now look where the Red Bull is in front of him.
Oh, right, okay, yeah, he is struggling quite badly. Yeah, he is.
It's just going to get worse throughout this lap. Watch the traction, ready? Watch that Sauber. Let's see what he can do. Yeah, there he is. That's not gone too well for him, has it?
That's unfortunate. Oh, he's going to. I'm going to start boredom, actually, as he's going to try and get his way back to the pit.
Yeah, I'm gonna jump onto the first four then, because they are, well, first two, pretty close.
The rain has brought this race so tight together.
Yeah, it took Pear's lead away.
And Davey, coming into pits, is limping in. So Davey is trying to stay out, and it's not worked. The rain is coming down hard here. With only 8 laps to go including this one they're on lap 29. So, anything can
happen. Pear's going to go for the lead. Pear is going for the lead on Evansy. into turn number two, side by side with each other. It's all fair, it's very close and rubbing. But Perez just, well, not even, no, they're equal, they're dead equal. Now Perez just a 3-4 into there. Now he's ahead by a tire and a whole car. Into turn number three, anything going to happen? He's gone defensive just in case. John's on the back of MG as well.
So it's a three-way battle for the lead. They're all line and stern pretty much. So you've got three different constructors, three different drivers. You know, three, you know, different driving styles, you'd say, because,
yeah,
you know, they're all completely different drivers, you'd say, but, you know, they're all there battling for the lead, and in these difficult conditions, you can't discount either. In fourth, Smoking Herb somehow has dragged him.
Just like that.
No, he hasn't, actually. He hasn't dragged
just
him
like
up to fourth place. But
it's just lagged out. I'm not too sure if you just commented cursing, but you said his name and he's like, he's just lagged out. That's your fault, that one.
I'll take the blame, but look at the spray now, Wes. You think a couple of laps ago it was dry, and now look at it.
Not dry.
But it is not dry. Are drivers going to try and stay out on the inters, or will it get full wet too much before the end? Are we going to have a situation? Remember Silverstone last year?
I will ask him about your race. Sorry, didn't realise you were a gay poor. I'm not interested in Chicago. The rain thing, Austria is known for. Yep, there's Gary.
Yeah.
That's pretty good. No, Gary. This race is tighter than Spacey's pussy, apparently. We are past nine by a minute, so I'm going to say it.
Well, go. It's the that.
That was Ryan, Elf Ryan.
Straight up. This is getting a strangely erotic, this Grand Prix.
It's got wet as well.
Oh, God.
That's very funny, Elf.
It's going to be very interesting to see if anybody goes on the full wets. Because it is close.
Now, is that actually a message from Audi or is that? No, it is. And that is interesting. Find out what that is. I've gone on to the people on the thing. Sorry. I've gone too far down to my list. It is. I'm back, STB Pair. I think we'll win. He's in the lead, so that could be a good call. And it is full wets off of the racing line.
Phil tonight has gone on to full wets. He is the first driver to go on the full wet tyre.
It's a battle for second. John Digweed down the outside of Evansy into turn number three. He could do this, but then you're going to be on the full wet sort of side of things. Well, he's just on the racing line coming out the corner. He's got a bit of traction. He's still going to be top side, if anything. Now,
I'm going to be on board with Phil tonight.
Oh, it's quite close. Evan D stays ahead. Yeah, he's in the full wet.
Want to
see how he is.
See these full wets
off the racing line. Off the racing
it
line,
looks
perfect.
Very wet indeed.
Yes. Off the racing line, perfect. On the racing line, maybe not. But there's a lot of
spider. He's broke himself into turn two.
I wouldn't care if people pit it. I don't know if they are, but they're not pitting. They're not pitting
at the front
yet.
It's not quite full wet. Not quite. At a lap off. So difficult to judge though in these conditions. But just the drastic change. You know, if you watch this on YouTube, like after the race, just scroll back to when it was five laps ago and now look at it now. It's incredible.
Comes away, it's sixth, seventh. It's Alex Ham, which is pitting actually. He's pitting for full wet, I would must believe. You know, you're not gonna pit if you're right now for more inches, are you?
No.
It could be four wets now on this lap, to be fair to it. It may not have just been the right temperature or whatever.
Is any driver going to brave it and try and stay out?
Probably the leader pack, or the heavenly pair, I would think.
There's only a few laps to go, and it
being
a
short
lap.
There's good battles going on. It looks like it could be wets very soon. It's wets basically now-ish. It's definitely the cross point, isn't it?
Well,
now the racing line is
good. Has got decent traction, I suppose.
The racing line is starting to disappear. I feel like John Digweed may pit this lap. I don't know why I say John Digweed does just feel like he is.
No, he's not.
Neither.
None
of these are. None of these are. No, John Digweed does. John Digweed does. He thinks about it in the corner, then he does. Did go a little bit over the line to prefer to him.
It's hard conditions to judge, though.
But I think it's full wet. I think it's full wet on inters, and they're on inters. So if anyone crosses the line at this moment,
it was slicks and it was inters.
Yes. Yeah, so if they cross the line by like nothing, if it's of course you know just full fold, then no. But if they actually
John
attempted
didn't do
to,
that.
No, he attempted to break. He did break. so if anyone does go a little bit over, it's all okay, but...
Whoa!
No,
got
if he's
a
bit there,
a little bit wrong there.
Has he?
Well, no, he steered into the corner almost a bit too early, had to back out the corner. He almost hit the barrier there, but I think
it's
he had to drop it.
Waiter versus Davey. Davey's into sick now. Not going after
Davey. Davey has got that close. And you'd be amazed at the working range of these intermitters. That's the way it got damage. Yeah, it's got missing end plate. Yeah, you'd be amazed at the working range of these inters. They
it's full wet. I do think John's... I would think John B. Williams is just closing on them. He must be closing on them.
He's going to have a good... Well, undercut here.
Undercut.
Could be an undercut.
None of them are... Actually, they've all gone wide. They've all gone wide.
They're all struggling.
They've all basically nearly dropped it then. Oh no, there's the wall!
Outgoing
hit the wall.
He's only got spin plate. Is John Digweed going to take the lead of this race? He's not won an XRL race yet, but has that brilliant stretch field to come in a lap early than everybody else paid off. He's going to come down the pit straight now. The leaders are making their way out the pits. Is he going to jump them? It's going to be very tight as he exits turn one. He's going to have to run on that. He's going to have a run. He's going to have to go for it. He's in the spray. Look at the spray. It's unbelievable.
He can't see anything.
Is he going to have a go on the inside of Pear?
It's more like now
or never. No, he thinks better of it, but Pear's run a little bit wide. Is he going to have a
better exit?
Turn three. Pear's got a bit of a better exit. I don't do anything about it, though, into turn three. It's very tight. I'm not even eating my dinner anymore because this is just too entertaining.
Pear's got a little bit wide, but
John Digweed's got oversteer. No, nothing he can do. This is going to be so tight towards the end.
It's now or never.
Now or never for John Digweed. And Pear, of course, a race winner in XRL. John Digweed just wants that race win, you think?
He was a debut for Pear when he actually won it.
Was.
Like, but you always want fresher wets than your opponent, and it feels like the one lap fresher is going to make a difference because Evan's now on the back of John, and we're on the penultimate lap, so.
It was then a little bit of a lead now. John Digweed has outbraced himself a little bit. Has Evan's got a bit of a run on him? A little bit.
Not too much. Less than you would have expected him to have a run on. I feel like that may now be Pears. It was a very now or never moment.
John's gone off. Everybody's got second. But John is falling back a little bit through the field, unfortunately.
David Ass is there.
David
may not be on the
podium. There's a bit of a dark horse this race. And he's sneak onto the podium. That'd be tremendous.
I've had...
From where he started.
I've had some massive lag from myself. Good thing that didn't actually happen. I've just had everybody go off the road. Does look like Pears at the moment. Evansy is in second. It's really a fight for the keeping on the podium now.
There's a few battles further back as well. This is John Dewey. It's got a bit of a run on Evansy out the final corner. He's not going to do anything with it, but close. Good start. Maybe. Not going to have quite enough of a run, but up now. That's got them realised. It's the last bat. Now, John, he's so close to that Ferrari, he can't do anything about it. He's just still behind. He's waiting for another side for it to come.
I'm sadly having quite a bit of lag. Sorry to people.
Having lag, I'm not. Thankfully.
No, no, it's not. Yeah. It's just made you sort yourself out.
I should think it's going to close out this race. Again, he's... I don't really know who called the strategy right, I'm going to be honest. Because it's another one of them races where strategy come into it, tyres, the weather, we don't know. We don't know really what the optimal strategy was. I don't
lag
think
spike
anybody
for a guy.
Gets it.
Someone just had a lag spike on the last corner.
But someone come around the final corner. Is SGP is going to claim another win for GP2. He takes the race win in Austria. MZ does get the second place, and John Digweed does slot in.
John,
third.
John's happy with third. He's happy with third. Davey seventh.
Davey's in seventh at the moment. Outgoing's got 10 seconds worth of in-game penalties, so I'm asking about that. From the start at the back, he's going to get the sixth place, so that is a great result for us there, considering where he started. Davey, of course, getting that seventh place. He's not going to be too happy himself this race, because I know he started in 10th, but being the championship leader, you'd hope he was higher up. Phil's Knight doing a solid job to get into 8th. And Captain Waiter in 9th on the best of runs as well. His teammate in reserves are coming just behind him in 10th place, so...
How does the word has out of the weird race? He may have been the one that went lap too early on the inters or something like that. Because he looked like he was the one. Yeah,
weird race for him. A weird race for him, and it's a bit of a weird race for everybody because I don't really know what particularly happened. A lot of people heard the word is Flixbinder. He is Flixbinder. Why not?
Happy to end the race. Happy to end the race, I'm guessing.
He's just doing it for showboating, and it's not going to make any difference at all.
I got 0 points. He may have actually got a few places, that's what you never think about penalties.
It doesn't matter. Anyway, so, we all get the top three in the box. That was... Well... The weather definitely spiced that one out. Definitely. Mm. Does John Digweed speak?
Yeah.
I never heard him speak.
I believe so. I believe I heard him.
We'll invite him in anyway. We'll invite him in. It's cool. We've got this. Yeah,
I heard him at some point.
A very happy pair joining the party. I like that. You're hearing already. Come on.
He's more happy than the apple.
You're more happy than winning the F1 division race because, you know, he wouldn't be.
Yo, we got absolutely fucking blitzed coming into when the fucking rain come, didn't it?
Yeah, man.
I said the rain would come down hard.
Yeah, it definitely came down.
40 seconds and then all of a sudden me, you and who was it, outgoing like fucking angel.
Yeah, John Dee was close as well. Is John going to join the party or not?
I don't know if he may not actually have a mic. I don't think he has a mic actually.
Oh, no,
he doesn't have a mic, but he's here anyway.
So we will speak to the top three pair. Of course, winning again, you won yesterday with a more dominant win yesterday. You know, obviously, the conditions didn't really play into your favour today, but you did hold out for that win. You were very dominant in the opening stages, but you know, how nervous was that towards the end?
Oh, extremely nervous, man. I don't know if you saw it when I was on the options. I was trying to stay out until the rain came, but then I had to pit. I lost loads of time. And then I came out and John Digweed was just there. I was like, oh no.
You pitted for primes, which is really strange.
Yeah, I think the primes are better in the rain. That's why. More grip.
Fair enough. Well, you made all these calls and you just about hold up for that race win, so very well done for a second race win in a row. Like two consecutive days in XRL, so well done to you. Evan 2 will move on to you in second place.
That's a good point. That's a good point. You've just entered your name in like a list of very good drivers there, Pear, winning F1 and then GP2.
Yeah, Evan 2 will move on board to you anyway, second place. Bit of an up and down race because, you know, I think the rain did help in your favour because obviously a pair's big lead, it definitely got reduced. Just tell us your race from your end.
It's a good race. Obviously the rain helps, but pair was just miles ahead of fucking everybody. Only reason why we all caught to him was because I think some damage or tyres went. That's the only reason why. But you know, passing people, I enjoyed it. I'm happy with second. Just pair was too quick today. That's about it.
Alright, and well, are you happy with second place considering everything?
Yeah, I'm happy with second place. Obviously, I got a decent qualifying as well. So, you know, I made 2 places, 18 points, better than nothing, isn't it?
Yeah, so very well done to you, John. Don't forget your mic, so you know, you can send us a message or do whatever. But it's going to be Silverstone next week, 100% race distance.
Ooh.
For Silverstone. So that's something you lot have got to look forward to. Not done 100% since Australia, so as John Digweed has sent me a message. I know, you've got no mic. He tried to undercut at every possible opportunity. It just wasn't enough, but he had a good race, so well done to John for your third place there. So, yeah, 100% race distance around Silverstone. How much do you two do 100% race distances often?
Nope. 50%.
You don't really know what to expect. Yeah, so it's going to be very unpredictable for that race, so we'll join GP2 back next week for Silverstone. GP3, of course, is tomorrow with, well, F1XP is always out, but it'll be with Michael Captivator. F4 will be with XRL Bubbles, what a great gamer tag. And F5 will be with me again with Wes. So from us here in the party, from the podium to everybody at home, good night, everybody.